Good morning. Wow, it's good to see everyone here this morning. I'm Reuben Blackwell, and I'm your councilman for Ward 2 for this part of the city. Welcome to Arbor Day celebration, which the city celebrates annually. We appreciate you being here this morning. We have a great crowd, lots of students, and we like that. I know they like being out of class, I'm sure. Yes! Arbor Day celebrates the importance of trees and the importance of the great relationship that we have here on Earth and the stewardship that we must do to keep our Earth green and clean. And this morning we want to take our opportunity to celebrate the importance of trees, and we're going to talk about the planting of trees, and we're going to have a lot of fun doing so. At this time we would though like to ask the mayor of the city of Rocky Mount, David Combs, to come greet us and introduce some other special folks. Thank you.
Thank you, Reuben, and thank you all for being here last year. Some of you may have come to our celebration last year, and it's much warmer today than it was last year. Yeah. It was a chilly morning, and I didn't dress appropriately, so we're glad that you're here today. This is a great place to have this celebration. There's a lot of rebirth here in this neighborhood that was dormant for many, many years, and like flowers and plants and trees, it's come back to life, and we're glad to be here today. Some of you may not have been down to the Douglas Block since we renovated it, but it's a great new addition to the city of Rocky Mount, and we're very proud of it. I would like to recognize Councilmember W.B. Bullock and Councilmember Chris Miller is also here, and they're sitting over there with our city clerk, and we'd like to welcome all them here today. We do have some other department heads with us today, but they're scattered in, and want to welcome them as well. This is our 2012 Arbor Day celebration, and we're doing it down here really at the Booker T. Theater, which is a historic building here in Rocky Mount that's been renovated that we use. This is one of the challenges in Rocky Mount if you have something downtown. So whether it's a long train or not, we'll see. Got a long one, so I'm going to move ahead. This is a tradition that began in the United States over 130 years ago. We are participating in a tree planting to add to the thousands of trees the city of Rocky Mount has either given away or planted so far this year. As we mark this occasion with songs and dances from our invited performers, and I gotta tell you, every time after I leave this celebration, after seeing our young children here performing for us, I go away with a renewed attitude and always amazed at how much energy they have at that age. And so I wish I could bottle some of that and take it with me. But the planting and caring for trees in our community is a significant thing for the city of Rocky Mount. And on Arbor Day, individuals, civic organizations, and groups of every kind are encouraged to plant trees. This ceremony gives us an opportunity to express our sincere appreciation for the importance and usefulness of trees in our city. I'd like to recognize the members of the Tree Advisory Board, which is a citizens board appointed by the City Council, and to thank them for their dedication and participation in making our city more green and beautiful. As I call your name, if you're here, please stand or at least raise your hand. Mrs. Doris Cooper. Oh, they're behind me, okay. Mrs. Ann Wilgus. Mrs. Linda Tippett. Mrs. Dakota Sharp. Mrs. Laurel O'Neill. And Mr. Peter Gillian. Let's give them a round of applause. We do appreciate your contributions, and we are particularly glad to be able to plant today an Okami cherry, a snow goose cherry on this historic site. We've already planted one of them down here. There's construction on the other site that we're going to plant it, but that will be planted at a later date. And it's our hope that as we plant these trees through the years, as the trees grow, into maturity. It'll provide residents, our guests in this area, and employees that work down here, as well as passerbys, with a sense of added beauty, and will be a reminder of how beneficial trees are to all of us. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to Councilmember Blackwell to introduce some of our guests and our performers. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. We're going to ask Peter Gilliland, who is a local pastor here and a member of the Tree Advisory Board, to lead us in prayer. And after that, we're going to be really blessed today by the Baskerville Elementary School. They're going to perform for us a song and a dance. And then we're going to hear from one of my favorite bands in the Twin Counties region, the Nass Central Jazz Band. They came to my organization, OIC, last night and had me on the floor dancing to Stevie Wonder. I don't know what you're going to do today, but we had a lot of fun a couple of weeks ago. At this time, Pastor Gilliland, if you would come lead us in prayer. And then after that, if we would have the performances from our local schools, we'd appreciate it.
How blessed is the man or the city that does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers, but their delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law they meditate day and night. And he will be planted like a tree firmly set by the streams of water, which yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. And in whatever he does, he prospers. The wicked are not so. Would you pray with me? Almighty God, sovereign of the universe, king of all, and Lord and creator of all, we thank you this day for the day that you have given us, for the beauty of it, and for this place and this city that we love. And we thank you for this opportunity to be reminded of the beauty of your creation and to be reminded of our responsibility to tend your creation. And Lord, as we plant this tree symbolically and practically, and as we think of the beauty and the benefits that we have simply in the trees around us, Lord, we ask that you would continually remind us of our place as curators of your world, our place in caring for that which you have entrusted to us. But also, Lord, as we plant and tend the trees, as we look at the beauty of the trees of this city, Lord, we ask that you would continually remind us that the trees mean nothing apart from the people, and that as we tend to the life of these trees and their health, may we also tend to the life and the health and the true well-being of our people. And that as we grow these trees, may we even be reminded of these young people and the lives that they represent as we plant and tend their lives, that we may be truly a city built on righteousness, that we may know your continuing presence and your continuing blessing here. Grant it, O Lord, that this city may be a place where your kingdom truly comes and your will truly is done. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, amen.
Do.
Then the man in the back row here, the back row here. Ladies and gentlemen, we've just heard from two award-winning institutions in Rocky Mount. Baskerville Elementary School was recognized for outstanding academic performance in North Carolina. Let's give our children a hand from Baskerville. And you've just heard from one of the best bands in North Carolina. Come on, let's clap our hands for Nash Central Middle School. At this time, we would like to hear from our officials that will present various awards and proclamations. You hear again from our mayor. We're going to give awards to our poster contest winners that the Tree Advisory Board has selected. And then Bill Lewis, who is a Nash County Ranger, will also present Tree Line Awards because we are Tree City USA. We believe in trees in Rocky Mount. So at this time, if we'd like to turn our attention to our mayor and our other platform guests.
Thank you again, and just to make this official, I am going to make a proclamation here to proclaim today as the Arbor Day in the City of Rocky Mount, and this just reads, City of Rocky Mount, Proclamation, March 30th, 2012, is hereby designated as Arbor Day in the City of Rocky Mount, and its observance is committed to all of our citizens, signed by Mayor David Combs, and I'm going to present this to a couple of members of our tree committee over here. So, thank you.
As I call the winners' names, will you please come to the stage, please? For the first place winner is Holly Farmer, Bendy New Elementary School. Holly will get a $30 Walmart card, 1 year family membership to Children's Museum, a school bag with assorted school supplies, a calculator, and a medallion and trophy. Congratulations, Holly. Our second place winner, Noah Jello, Falls Rose Baptist Church School, will get a $20 Walmart card, a school bag with assorted school supplies, calculator, medallion, and trophy. Our third place winner, Rachel Brooks, Rocky Mount Preparatory School, will get a $10 Walmart card, school bag with assorted school supplies, calculator, medallion, and trophy. And our winning teacher is from Bendy New Middle School, Mrs. Czar. I hope I pronounced your name right, Mrs. Czar. No, she gets a $20 Walmart card. I don't think she's present. Let's give our winners a big hand.
All right, give them another big hand as they're going back to you. That was great. That was wonderful. Participation is everything. Nothing happens unless we participate. And I'd like to say that about that group. They're participating, and we're enjoying the benefits of it. And if anybody knows the history of Rocky Mount, we've got some connections to jazz and blues. Lately, it feels like the blues. But we're turning it around, and we appreciate that music. A little bit of history about me, not because it's about me, but just so you get a comfort level about this and my involvement in this as Nash County Ranger. I was born in Rocky Mount, spent the first 6 years of my life in Riverside Apartments when it was there. Thanks a lot, Floyd. Things have changed a lot since I was here. My father was with People's Bank, original People's Bank right here in Rocky Mount. We moved out of town because of People's Bank, and every time I came back, one thing that happens when you grow up from being small to older, it seems like everything shrinks. Seems like it's a lot smaller than you remembered it when you were little. Well, when I came back, the trees were bigger. And I thought, this is great. This is good. This is the way it's supposed to be. And Rocky Mount has always been a tree-conscious city, and it's made a difference over the years. It's probably a consistency that is rivaled by no other. And I think that is because of participation by officials, citizens, towards our trees in this city. So with that being said, I have a couple of awards I want to present to the residents of Rocky Mount. That's the thing that ties us all together. We can talk about dignitaries and different individuals holding position, but one thing we all are is residents of Rocky Mount. And that's how we share together in these type of awards, because we all do different things. We're all different parts of the body that have different functions and carry these things out. So, for the Tree City Award today, it's my pleasure to be here and to do this because we are the North Carolina Forest Service working predominantly in the rural parts of the county, but we have requests in the city limits for tree care and any requests we have from a resident in that regards. So our involvement does bring us in the city, and I'm glad to be a part of this here today. This is about Arbor Day. This is about the city of Rocky Mount, the 15th largest city in the state of North Carolina, and one of 70 cities that in North Carolina. Rocky Mount is one of 70 cities in this state to receive this award, and there's approximately 534 cities and towns in Rocky Mount. So we're talking about the top 13% of cities in the state that Rocky Mount's a part of, and one of only 3,400 cities and towns in the country. And that's an estimated 25,000 cities and towns in this country. Again, the top 13% of cities and towns are receiving this type of recognition. Tree City USA began in 1976 during our bicentennial celebration, the 200-year history of this country. And it was a project co-sponsored by the National Association of State Foresters, USDA Forest Service, Department of Agriculture Forest Service, the National League of Cities, and U.S. Conference of Mayors are all co-sponsors in this award. The Tree City USA program is a partnership between the North Carolina Forest Service and the National Arbor Day Foundation. Awards are presented annually to cities and towns that demonstrate a commitment to making their communities more livable by planting and caring for trees. Very important distinction there. Not just putting a tree back, but caring for the tree that you have, making it as healthy and last as long as it possibly can. And as everything else, trees can't last forever. So you do the best you can until you have to remove it, and then you put another one back. And that's an important part of what forestry is able to do. Rocky Mount has once again met these four criteria to accomplish this award. A public tree ordinance, establishing policies for street and park trees, a tree board, and a city department responsible for the care and management of the community's trees. A community forestry program with an annual expenditure of at least $2 per capita. An annual Arbor Day observance and celebration that benefits may provide to this city. Today's celebration qualifies it for this year. For a community forestry program to be effective, it takes support and commitment from the entire community. In Rocky Mount, the community forestry program thrives because of the combined dedication of the tree board members, the city staff, elected officials, business community, homeowners, and all residents who take pride in improving the quality of life in Rocky Mount through environmental stewardship. And I mentioned here, and off that phrase environmental stewardship, since we have so many children here, I just want to make mention of something. There's a new movie that has just recently come out called The Lorax. I don't know if you've seen it or not, but it's a Dr. Seuss story from long ago. And in a Dr. Seuss way, approaches the concern that we should have for our trees and our environment. And that concern, I don't want to misrepresent it. I want to make sure everybody understands what the importance of trees management is. It's about sustainability. And that's a big word, kids, I know. But what that means is a tree can last as long as it will if you take care of it, and then it can be replaced, and another tree can take its place, and it's a continuing cycle. And that's what we want to do with our trees, is take care of them until they need to be replaced. Let's make this cycle. Let's let this thing continue and keep happening. So on behalf of Arbor Day Foundation and the North Carolina Forest Service, I'm honored to present Rocky Mount with your 9th Tree City Award. Sometimes accomplishments in succession are an even greater thing. You've done the same thing. You know how to do it. Why lay it down and quit doing it? So I think to accomplish this on a continuing basis like that is even a greater reward. Now, one of the reasons you're able to accomplish this is this second award, and this is the Tree Line USA Award. This is specifically about your utilities department and how they interact with your trees and your forest land within the city limits. So this is a Rocky Mount success story. We want to hear some success stories, don't we? Success story. We have many of them, but this is one of them with our utilities department. And I'd like to present the City of Rocky Mount Utilities Department with its 6th Tree Line USA Award. Rocky Mount's utility department is one of 2 in the state and 152 in the nation utilities department to receive this award. So we're even getting a little bit tighter on our excellence as far as comparison to our whole country, as a matter of fact. The Tree Line USA program is sponsored by the National Arbor Day Foundation in cooperation with a National Association of State Foresters and recognizes public and private utilities across the nation that demonstrate practices that protect and enhance America's urban trees. Trees and utility service lines are integral components of every community. By necessity, they must coexist in close proximity with each in its own way to be essential in our high standard of living. We've got to have power lines, we've got to have trees, and they've got to coexist comparable to each other so that we can enjoy both. The Tree Line USA program promotes the dual goals of dependable utility service and abundant, healthy trees in America's communities. To meet these goals, criteria have been developed that highlight for the public as well as utility workers key practices that need to be followed. So let me just briefly read these practices that the utilities department have followed. And I want to do this because you need to be reminded of what's going on in your city. You might not be doing this, but there's somebody else taking care of this for us, and that's our utilities department here in the city. Here's what they do. Quality tree care, which incorporates proper pruning methods, such as avoiding tree topping and proper trenching and tunneling methods to reduce the destruction of tree roots. Now, everybody here might not know what I'm talking about, but the utilities department knows what I'm talking about, and that's what they're doing. Number 2, annual worker training program on following proper pruning and trenching and tunneling practices. Number 3, tree planting and public education program in which the utility expends at least 10 cents per customer on tree planting and distributes educational information on trees to all customers. Number 4, but tree-based energy conservation program, which makes special consideration of the value of trees in conserving energy and an Arbor Day celebration as we're having today. So the North Carolina Forest Service publicly recognizes utilities that meet these requirements for their contribution to better community forests. This recognition serves not only as an award to the conscientious employees who make it possible, it also makes a statement to the community at large about cooperation, goodwill, and the need for continuous tree care. On behalf of the National Arbor Day Foundation and the North Carolina Forest Service, I'm honored to present the City of Rocky Mount Utilities Department with your 6th Tree Line USA Award. And lastly, also, I just want to make mention before I leave one thing that for you kids and everybody here, really. I have a special friend here today. He's kind of a big guy. He's kind of brown. And I just want to introduce him. He'll be here the rest of the day when we're through, so you can get a picture with him and hug him. Give him a big wave if you will. He likes to get waves. He likes to feel at home when he comes to town. Anybody can holler out, what's his name? Oh, yeah, we've been to the school. We've seen you. This is Smokey Bear. So he's going to be hanging around for the rest of the day, and I hope you get to sit down with him, maybe get your picture. But thank you so much for participating in this program today. I'm glad to be in Rocky Mount. Thank you.
Thank you, Ranger Lewis. Rocky Mount is really blessed with wonderful, diverse educational institutions, and among the best is our beloved Our Lady of Perpetual Help. Their students are going to come now and perform a song for us, and after that we'll have our keynote speech by our very own city manager, Charles Penny. At this time, let's receive Our Lady of Perpetual Help.
Thank you. Johnny Appleseed. John Chapman was called Johnny Appleseed because he carried apple seeds everywhere he went. He traveled across America planting apple trees, apple seeds, whilst visiting the new settlers on their farms. Johnny Appleseed visited the Indians in their villages and planted apple trees everywhere he visited. John Chapman was a friend to the pioneer and a friend to the Indians. He wanted everyone to have apple trees. His birthday is celebrated on September 26th. Today, the Our Lady of Perpetual Help Catholic School would like to sing Johnny Appleseed Blessing. We hope you like it as much as we do.
Good morning. I always wanted to do that poem. I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree. However, this morning I got trumped by some elementary school children for my Lady of Perpetual Help, so I'll give you your due. And thank you for reciting the poem that I wanted to use. But as I read the poem, and you listen to the words, the way the tree stretches its arms out all day. And then it says that a tree that looks at God all day, but only God can make a tree. The words had such meaning. And so I give you your due, Our Lady of Perpetual Help. But there's nothing as lovely as a tree. When you think about trees and you look around our environment, trees soften the environment. When you look at buildings downtown, long time ago, we didn't have trees in the downtown. So you just had buildings. And any place you look at a downtown and you see only sidewalks and buildings, they need trees. The buildings may be pretty, but trees add to the beauty and enhance the beauty of the building, and it softens the environment. So that's my lesson on trees. Good morning. We'd like to just recognize Dr. Jackson, Dr. Anthony Jackson, superintendent for Nash Rocky Mount School System. Thanks for being here, Dr. Jackson. This morning we gathered to celebrate the value of trees to the city of Rocky Mount and proclaim the importance of the forestry program in our community and in other communities across the country. As you heard in the proclamation, the idea to designate a day to honor trees was originally conceived by J. Sterling Morton. In January of 1872, he proposed a tree planting holiday called Arbor Day. And just think, in Rocky Mount, North Carolina, on March 30th, 2012, we're still celebrating Arbor Day. On April 1872, his dream became a reality when Nebraska became the first state to formally celebrate Arbor Day. On that day, thanks to the efforts of civic groups, churches, and schools, more than 1 million trees were planted across the state of Nebraska.
This year we've chosen to plant two trees, an Okami cherry and a snow goose cherry. Now, I was a little bit taken aback when I started to read this information on these trees, because these trees are something. The Okami cherry grows upward of 15 to 20 feet tall and as much as 20 feet wide upright with a shaped oval silhouette. Just imagine 20 feet wide. Now, I was getting concerned that that was going to be the trunk of the tree, because that'd be awfully big down here. The dark green 1 to 2.5 inch long leaves cast medium shade beneath the tree. In early spring, the trees are decorated with a multitude of single pink blooms with red calluses and reddish flower stalks. Last week, we were in D.C., and what were they doing in Washington, D.C. last week? The Cherry Blossom Festival. So we're having our own Cherry Blossom Festival in Rocky Mount today. The snow goose cherry grows upward of 15 to 20 feet tall and 20 feet wide upright, again with a shaped oval silhouette. New foliage emerges with a bronze tint, maturing to dark green, and white flowers emerge just before leaves in spring. I think J. Sterling Morton said it best. Other holidays repose upon the past. Arbor Day proposes for the future. A concern for the future is why we're here today. Although we choose just one day each year to formally celebrate the value of trees, our regard for the environment is reflected by our actions throughout the year. Through the City of Rocky Mount's membership in the American Public Power Association Tree Power Program, we plant and maintain more trees now than at any other time in the city's history. Since the inception of the program in 1991, we have planted over 60,400 trees in the city and have given away nearly 49,000 tree seedlings to our residents. The City Council appointed a Tree Advisory Board to oversee the Tree Power Program and the city's tree ordinance. We sincerely appreciate the service these citizens give to making our community more green and beautiful. Collectively, these actions demonstrate our commitment to the environment and a concern for the quality of life of our citizens. However, our work is far from done. We continue to initiate major tree planting projects at several locations throughout Rocky Mount. And I'm just going to pause for a minute and say, if you remember back in August when Hurricane Irene came through, God sort of took some trees away, but he will bring them back. And it's our responsibility to be good stewards of God's earth. And that's what the City of Rocky Mount is doing. And you can help by, one, coming to City Hall, as many of your parents have done, picking up the seedlings, replanting, and we will continue to plant trees throughout our city. The planting of these two trees is just the beginning. As you drive around town, you will notice the improvements created by the addition of trees to public facilities, along streets and corridors, and at other areas in our community. Trees not only enhance the beauty of the area, but they also help reduce air and noise pollution, cleanse our air and water, and enable us to conserve energy. Every tree is a living testament to our belief in the value and benefit of a thriving urban forest. In cooperation with area organizations such as the Tree Power Board and Keep America Beautiful, the City of Rocky Mount is working to leave a lasting legacy of environmental stewardship for generations to come. Please enjoy the trees in our city and also enjoy our city. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, let's give them a rousing round of appreciation. Nat Central High School Jazz Band.
Baskerville's going to help me with advice from a tree.
Yes, sir.
Stand tall and proud. Sink your roots into the earth. Be content with your natural beauty. Go out on a limb. Drink plenty of water. Remember your roots and enjoy the view. Thank you. I want to thank all of you on behalf of the Tree Advisory Board for coming to our 2012 Arbor Day celebration. And I would especially like to express our appreciation to all of our performers. Let's give them another hand. Your attendance shows your commitment to the future of our environment. This is just one day out of many that we need to pay attention to our natural surroundings and accept responsibility for its well-being. Take time to take care of our beautiful trees and to realize the many important roles they play in contributing to the positive quality of life and environmental health for our city. Also, take a moment to appreciate the beauty they provide to Rocky Mount. As we close today, we have the honor of having the D.S. Johnson step team to perform for our finale, which we just had. As you leave, Nash Central Jazz Band will play for your enjoyment. Again, thank you so much for coming.